Hello friends and welcome to my channel. So friends, in today's session I'm gonna discuss the difference between the classical poetry and the romantic poetry. So actually this video is a requested video, so thank you so much for requesting this. So in relation to this topic, in this session I'm also gonna discuss about the classification of the periods of English literature along with the features of classical and romantic poetry. So let's start. So at first we have to peep into the history of English literature. So now we have to know about the time span of classical age. So classical age's time span was 1200 BCE to 455 CE. So friends, now we have to know that what is BCE, what is CE. So BCE means before the common era, okay? CE means common era. Friends, in English literature you will find another term which is BC. It means that before Christ, okay? So now we have to know about the periods of English literature in which the poetry was in mainstream, okay? So at first we have pre-Chaucerian poetry. The time span is 500 CE to 1340, okay? And this pre-Chaucerian poetry includes all the poetry of the Anglo-Saxon period, poetry in the medieval age before Chaucer, okay? And then we have the age of Chaucer poetry, means Chaucerian poetry. And the time span is 1340 to 1400, okay? Then we have poetry in the age of revival, means after Chaucer. And the time span is 1400 to 1550. After this, we have the Elizabethan poetry in the Elizabethan age. And the time span of Elizabethan era is 1558 to 1603. After this, we have the poetry of the Puritan age. And then the Restoration Age, okay? So then we have the poetry of the Neoclassical period of Augustan age and the age of Chaucer, and the time span is 1700 to 1790 or 1798. And lastly we have the poetry of the Romantic age and the time span is 1790 or 1798 to 1837. Then after Romantic age we have the other periods like the Victorian period, the modern era, the postmodern era, okay? So now we have to know that what is romantic poetry and classical poetry. So according to various critics like Walter Peter, there is actually existed two types of art. One is romantic and the other one is classic. So art is the creation of beauty. Romantic art tries to create the kind of beauty which is strange, mysterious and uncommon. Whereas classical art tries to create the kind of beauty which is orderly, familiar and significant. So from this point it is clear that classical art is a kind of straightforward art. It has a smoothness, straightforwardness and orderness. On the other hand, romantic art is distinguished by the qualities of strangeness, elements of mystery, etc. Okay? We have to know a bit about romantic movement. So English romantic movement started towards the end of the 18th century and continued till the 30s of the 19th century, means 1830s, okay? So it can be roughly dated from 1780 and ended round about 1830 or 1837. So one German poet called Friedrich Schlegel first used the term romantic to describe literature. According to him, literature depicting emotional matter in an imaginative form. So thus, romanticism turned away from the 18th century emphasis on reason and artifice. In place of this, the romantics embraced imagination and naturalness. The romantic poets believed that feelings and emotions can create poetry. They also believed that poetry should speak the personal experiences and emotions in simple, unadorned language, okay? So Wordsworth defined good poetry as the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings. So now we have to know about the features of classical poetry. So actually, classical poetry refers the Greeks, Grecian or Romantic poetries, okay? But if we take the term broadly, then it can be said that classical art also covers the works written in imitation of it. Means, if we take the term broadly, then classical poetry also covers all the poems of English literature which bear the elements of the classical masters, the Greek, the Grecian, the Roman poetic arts, okay? So in the classical poetry, we have the following features. First one is clearness, then we have the sense of proportion, then restraint, then calmness, realism, a combination of passion and thought, and chivalry. After this, we have the features of romantic poetry. So at first we have escapism, means escape from the real world into an imaginary one. Then we have imaginative faculty, same as escapism. Then we have love of nature, cult or passion of beauty, supernatural elements, addition of strangeness to beauty, and love for the past. And also in some of the romantic poems like John Keats's poems, we will find the element of Hellenism, which means affinity to the Greeks, okay? So after this, we have to know what are the differences between classical poetry and romantic poetry. So at first we have classical art form have the qualities of clearness, sense of proportion, restraint, calmness, grace of form. And on the other hand, romantic art form have the qualities of curiosity, excitement, enthusiasm, aspiration, freedom and restlessness. Repose satisfies the classic. On the other hand, adventure attracts the romantic. And then we have classical poetry is metrical, it is not rhymed. And then romantic poetry is rhymed, okay? Then we have our next difference, which is classical art is objective, means in classical art forms or poetries, the poets think more of the world around them than of themselves. And their best work can be found in epic and dramatic forms, not in lyric forms, okay? So the poets of the romantic poetry or the romantic poets likes to share or express their own feelings and experience in their work. And they did it in lyric form, okay? After this, we have the next difference, which is classical art or classical poetry have a feeling of calmness, soothness, okay? And on the other hand, romantic poetry or romantic art is distinguished by the quality of excitement. Then after this, we have the use of conceit in classical poetry. Conceit means use of metaphorical expressions in classical poetry and the use of wit. In contrary to this, we have a sense of melancholy in romantic poetry. After this, we have our next difference, which is in the classical poetry or in the classical art, the poets do not want to live in the realms of imagination. On the other hand, the romantic poets want to escape from the real or mundane world of pain to the world of imagination, to the world of joys and happiness. That's it. So friends, this was a brief discussion about the difference between classical poetry and the romantic poetry. Hope that this video will help you. So thank you so much for watching this video.